Welcome to the UJSON Stadium in Calabar, the capital of South.
Hello and welcome to this African third Group F 2014 World Cup qualifier between hosts Nigeria and Kenya at the UJSON Stadium in the southern Nigerian coastal town of Calabar. The Super Eagles of Nigeria playing their first competitive match since last month's African Nations Cup triumph in South Africa. There's the trophy, winning the trophy for the first time in 19 years after beating Burkina Faso in the final. Coach Stephen Keshi, who lifted Nigeria's second African Cup of Nations in 1994 as captain, has been warning his squad that the party is over. We'll listen to the Kenyan national anthem.
Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen.
The Harambee Stars of Kenya, who've never beaten the Super Eagles of Nigeria. The champions of Africa, the Super Eagles, also super positive today. Stephen Keshi has selected Victor Moses, Brown Idiu, and the recalled Obafemi Martins as his three-pronged strike force. Adeyi, like he did in the African Nations final, replacing the injured Emmanuel Emeniki. Keshi keeps faith with his young central defensive pairing of Godfrey Obabona and Kenneth Omeru, so impressive in South Africa. Sunshine Stars right back Solomon Kwambe fills in for the suspended Efe Ambrose, with Chelsea's powerhouse John Mikel Obi in central midfield. Obafemi Martins preferred to the informed striker Ahmed Musa. He's recalled to the squad after missing out on the African Nations. For Kenya, coach Adil Amruchi, in his first match in charge of the Harambee Stars, who have just 1 point in Group F, he's also made some enforced changes. Defender Abdallah Yuma is out through injury, with the experienced Malinga Monandi switching to fullback. Celtic's Victor Wanyama will be looking to stamp his authority in midfield, with young David Gueteri and Francis Kahata the threat going forward, with the experienced Dennis Oleich leading the line. Adil Amruchi says his team have not come to defend today, and his players have been talking about having a strong mentality as they take on the African champions in their own backyard. Kenya's skipper, goalkeeper Arnold Origu, tossing up there with the Nigerian captain as well. And there's been a lot of talking between both camps in the build-up to this vital qualifier. Kenya unhappy with the hospitality they've received in Nigeria, complaining of flight delays, poor accommodation and training facilities, all claims denied by Nigeria. And as an added incentive, if needed, the Kenyan Football Federation today offering 1 million in Kenyan currency to the Harambee Stars if they beat the Super Eagles within the next 90 minutes or so. A lot of money, a lot of prestige riding on this one. Referee Joshua Bondu of Botswana maybe has a tough job on his hands in the opening exchanges. We're looking at the Kenyan coach there, born in Algeria but of Belgium nationality. And the Kenyans, who've never beaten Nigeria in 13 matches in a team huddle. There's a victorious Nigerian coach from the African Cup of Nations, 51-year-old Stephen Keshi, coming to a bit of criticism before the African Nations over his team selection, leaving out a number of experienced stars. But one of them who was left out in the frame there, Martins, has been recalled for this one. Sunday Mbah, also one of the up-and-coming stars of Nigeria, scoring the winner in that African Cup of Nations final. A slight breeze in this southern coastal town of Calabar. The pitch looks in excellent condition. This is the third group match in Group F, and we get underway with Nigeria in their green strip, kicking from right to left. An early touch for Chelsea midfielder Mikel, and Martins, who'll be keen to impress his coach, getting an early shot in there. And the Kenyan coach, who said pre-match that he is taking this game in a positive manner, looking for the 3 points, will be a bit concerned with the time and space that the Nigerian number nine had there. Origi of Kenya getting us on the way, and that's a free kick. Elderson Ekielili of Nigeria going through his man. Kenya just 1 point in Group F. They're rock bottom, still to score a goal. Nigeria with a win and a draw top the group with 4 points. Namibia and Malawi, the two other teams, Namibia with 3 points and Malawi with two. The game taking place in Africa today. This long road to Brazil and 2014. Kenya have never qualified and have never won away in Nigeria, only winning twice away in their international history. Dennis Oleich, the Kenyan skipper, the danger man for Kenya, and Victor Wanyama, the Celtic midfielder, the big name in the Kenyan side. He'll be looking to dominate this strong Nigerian midfield. And the ball, a hopeful long diagonal ball, looking to get use the space on the wings. Nigeria, lots of pace from the fullbacks pushing forward, and from the likes of Victor Moses and Brown Adeyu. Victor Moses, one of the stars of the African Cup of Nations tournament, began as an impact player but cemented his place by the time the final came around. It's been a fantastic 12 months for the 22-year-old Chelsea star. There's Brown Adeyu on that right-hand side, winning the throw-in. Solomon Kwambe coming in for the injured Effie Ambrose with the long ball. Mikkel in his preferred defensive midfielder role. Given away, and a chance for Oleich on the attack for Kenya. They've got support on the right hand side, and he wins a throw in. 28 years of age, Oleich scored a hat trick for Kenya against Libya last month, giving the Kenyans heart going into this World Cup qualifier. Close to capacity crowd at the Ujay Stadium. Happy hunting ground this for the Super Eagles. And again, sloppy passing from the African champions. Elderson Akili getting forward, the Sporting Braga man, loves to get forward. Victor Moses. And good 1-2. Chance to make inroads here. And it's the first corner of the match. The Chelsea winger. And he's going to take the corner himself. Stephen Keshi talking tactics. Chance for Nigeria. Poor corner, to be fair, goes out of play. Martins doing well with the header. Kwambe. Just 19 years of age. Sunday Mba. Saw some crucial goals in the African Cup of Nations, including the winner in the final, the decisive, the only goal against Burkina Faso. Mikel there. Origi unhappy with the man in front of him. Swung into the box. Origi comes out and claims it. One of the few foreign-based players for Kenya. Applies his trade in Norway for Lillestrøm, and has been a regular in the international side since he made his debut back in 2005. The Kenyans with a compact midfield. First game in charge for Kenya's new coach, Adil Amrouche, looking to cause an upset, the former Burundi coach. And would you believe Kenya have had three coaches since the World Cup qualifying campaign began for them back in 2011. Amrouche taking over from acting coach James Ndura, who took over from Henri Michel, who departed in 2011. So they need a bit of stability, the Kenyans. Brown, today making headway on that right-hand side, the Dynamo Kiev man. And too quick there for Malingi Mwanandi. Another set piece for Nigeria. Cleared easily by the Kenyans. Well, Stephen Keshi warned his side at the celebrations. The party after last month's triumph was over, and eyes very much focused on Brazil next year. And he's a strong-willed manager, actually handed his resignation in reportedly 24 hours after the African Nations triumph. He was unhappy with the federation officials from Nigeria after they booked a flight home for the squad straight after the quarter-final with the favourites of the competition, Ivory Coast. And the 51-year-old performed a U-turn after Nigeria's sports minister intervened, persuading him to stay on. only the second man to win the Nations Cup as a player and a coach, Stephen Keshi, following Egypt's Mahmoud El-Ghahari. Quite an achievement. The first Nigerian to win the Cup of Nations as a coach as well. And the Super Eagles with Martins can build again on this right-hand side. We haven't seen too much so far of Victor Moses on the left, but it's Brown Adeyu and fullback Solomon Kwambi there, pushing the Kenyans back. Cross into the box. Cleared by David Ochieng. Arnold Origi there. Comes from a footballing family. His uncle Mike was pretty famous in Belgium, and his father and cousins also in the professional game. Quite a young side, this Kenyan side. Nigeria too, especially the central defending partnership of Kenneth Amuru and Godfrey Obabona, also 19 and 22, keeping out the vastly experienced Joseph Yobo, who can't even get in the squad for this World Cup qualifier. The two young defenders so impressive in South Africa. Kenya playing a dangerous game in their own penalty area. They're being forced deeper and deeper. Origi doing well to clear on the quite bobbly surface. The Nigerian coach actually praising the playing surface here at the UJ Stadium in the run-up to this game. Describing it as the best in the country. Bona to Amiru. Bona there, one of a number of Nigerian players who play in the Nigerian Premier League. One of the changes that Stephen Keshi has made, bringing more domestic-based players into the international setup, at the expense of some of the more bigger names who play in Europe. Once again, Kenya just managing to keep possession but can't really do anything with it. A pressing game from the Nigerians, and that's going to be another free kick. Joshua Bondo, the referee from Botswana. Victor Moses, who switched wings to get into the game, is a man chopped down. The referee, though, deciding actually it was the offence was the other way round. From the angle, those watching on the monitor, seemed like it was a free kick to Nigeria, but it's Kenya. Origi signaling that it's a throw-in. No foul given. Close ball there. Olech, the runner, but well cleared by Kenneth Amuru. Here's Adeyu, who's switched wings with Moses. He's on the left now. Mikel, that central battle with Victor Wanyama. Haven't seen much of him, the Celtic man, in these opening exchanges. The first quarter of an hour of this World Cup qualifier. In Group F, Nigeria, the Super Eagles against the Harambee Stars of Kenya. That's a poor ball. Nigeria. Yeah, he's not happy. Mikel, who's had a good season for Chelsea in the English Premier League, signed a contract extension there recently, taking him through to 2017. Good defensive work there from Brian Mandela. Martins was the man who would have been in the clear. Just an example with that ball bouncing so high of how hard this pitch is. Work now, space for Adeyu to try and work an angle for Nigeria. Here he is again. But Kenya defending in numbers. Adel Amrouche saying we'll be positive, but they're very much looking to defend deep and hit Nigeria on the counter-attack. Just the two draws against Nigeria in 13 meetings, one of which was in a World Cup qualifier for France, 98, which ended one apiece. They would love a point here. No foul there. Ogeni Onanza shrugging his man on for Martins, who can't quite control it. Just a bit too high for him. But there's a threat. Scrappy so far, misplaced passes. Quambi on the overlap, can't quite pull it back far enough. And Kenya can work their way free. Handball. Musical accompaniment to this World Cup qualifier. Right by the sea here in Calabar. Gatiri does well, but Akili, I haven't seen much of him, the number three, getting forward for Nigeria, as he loves to do. Scored his first international goal in the African Nations Cup semi-final against Mali. The Sporting Braga man who's keeping out the more famous Tairu in that left-back position for Nigeria. Here's Kenya, though, on the attack. Free kick there, surely. The captain, Dennis Oleks, the man brought down. And it was Kenneth Amuro with the hefty push and just caught the Kenyan skipper as he followed through unintentionally, but it's Olich feeling that one. Plays his trade in France in Ligue 1 with Ajaccio after several seasons at Auxerre. And he's represented his country for over 10 years now, making his debut against Nigeria in a 3-0 defeat back in 2002. First real opportunity for Kenya. 30 yards from goal. Vincent Onyema, the Nigerian captain, is the voice you can hear, and the Nigerian wall stands firm. Disappointing free kick from Kenya. David Gatiri, the man taking that free kick, who impressed in the friendly against Libya last month. The Harambe Stars winning that one 3-0. Long kick forward from Onyema, looking for Martins, but straight back to his opposite number, Arnold Origi, in the Kenyan goal. Kenya have won three, drawn once, and lost once in their last five matches, so in a bit of form. Opportunity for Nigeria with Moses. Oh, good save from Origi. First real chance, Moses using his pace. And Arnold Origi did well to narrow his angle. And Moses with the left-footed shot. He's actually came off the Kenyan defender, Munandi, there. But it's a corner which Moses will take. Going deep again. Header! Cleared off the line. Two goal-scoring opportunities in the space of a minute. It was Brown Adeyu there. And Origi, it looked like the man with the athletic save. Once again, the ball bouncing hard and high on this pitch, but there's a threat from Victor Moses, and here's the header, and Origi was beaten, but cleared off the line. By Malinga Munandi. In the 23rd minute. Always a debate about having defenders on the post, on the goal line for free kicks and corners. But always seems to make sense to me to have at least one man there. And it paid off for the Kenyans to keep the score goalless. But that might change here with Adeyi there looking to flick it over his man, but straight to Origi, who can get the Kenyans on the attack. Francis Kahata opting to strike from distance, never troubling Onyema. Mikel with Ekieli getting forward. First foray down that left-hand side for the Nigerian left-back, who gets back onto his feet. But Kenya surrounding their man. Just the one forward. Dennis Oliech, the Kenyan captain, and the Kenyans playing so deep, inviting the Super Eagles on the attack. Martins to Moses. Adeyu is offside. Struck it well. The number eight. Let's have a look at the replay. The Dynamo Kiev man finding the goal. Has been criticised for being rather wasteful in front of goal. He's got plenty of power and ability, but not the most clinical of finishes. But he found the net there, but unfortunate to have it ruled out for offside. It's Nigeria increasing the pressure on the visitors, who again clear their lines. Another corner. Monandi, the 32-year-old, Origi stretching and does well. Really was a tremendous triumph for Nigeria last month in South Africa. 19 years they had to wait for their third African Cup of Nations. And Stephen Keshi's policy of not playing the players with big egos, that's a booking there. Wanyama with the kick from behind on Sunday Mbar, the Celtic man, the first man into Joshua Bondo's book. Made his debut, the Kenyan, against Nigeria as a 15-year-old. Looking for Adeyi, but he's offside. Not happy with the decision. Yes, Nigeria. The selection policy of the coach was criticised before the tournament for leaving out a number of star names like Martins there and Peter Ongwenye. But the success, the blend paid off. Joseph Yobo, the veteran of six Cup of Nations, described the latest squad as the most unified that he has known in his many years with the Nigerian international setup. And a number of good youngsters coming through. He's lost his place in the side to the likes of Kenneth Amiru and Godfrey Obabona. But success still eludes them at World Cup level. Qualified for South Africa in 2010. An African nation still, though, to win the greatest cup of them all. But here comes Ekiele. Chance to get the cross in. Fired in. And Martins, it went past him. Another opportunity, though, on the right-hand side. He's bundled over. A penalty? No. John Obi Mikel asking the Botswanan official for a penalty, but he was having none of it. But just earlier, we saw what left-back Elderson Ekiele is capable of. Really was a good delivery, hit with pace. But Martins and Adeyu couldn't quite get on the end of it. Just needing a touch, really. And it would have been the opening goal of the half an hour in Calabar. just a bit too long. Calabar in Cross River State in Nigeria, and the state of Cross River awarding every player in Nigeria's Nation Cup winning squad $180,000 plus a patch of land for their success. And I said earlier, the Kenyan Football Federation also offering the Kenyan team $1 million in Kenyan currency if they were to win against Nigeria today. Looking unlikely at the moment, but we'll see what they can do as they come away with Francis Kahata wasted. Muru can clear, looking for Moses, who's staying on that right-hand side now. Origi quickly off his line. Martins had really impressed for Levante. There's Kenny on the attack. And now Martins playing his trade in the American Football League. Good bit of skill there for Mohamed, looking for the far post, and Enyama was beaten there by the flight of the ball. Dennis Olech, the Kenyan skipper, was lurking dangerously at the far post, and a little warning to the Super Eagles. Again, it's Adia, rather, the man offside. Stephen Keshi not happy. Then Origi, the visiting goalkeeper, again quick off his line to clear the danger. Kenyan coach Adol Amruchu on the standing up on the touchline, waving his arms. And Kenya do get the free kick. Godfrey Abobona doing well there, using his body strength. But poor pass to Moses. Happy man so far, the former Burundi coach, with the score still at 0-0 as we approach 10 minutes to half time. Mikel. Hernandez claiming he was blocked there. And we're going to have our second booking of the game. Elderson Akele appeals against the yellow card. And he joins Kenya's Wanyama in Joshua Bondo's book. And it'll be a free kick from a useful angle. Francis Kahata. Plays for Thika United. 21-year-old, left-footed. He's going to look to test the goalkeeper. Oh, what a strike! What a strike! Vincent Enyama completely beaten. And it's the visitors who take the lead with 8 minutes to half-time. And the Kenyan coach is delighted, as are his teammates. And a fantastic free kick, left-footed with pace and precision, right in the top left-hand corner of Vincent Enyama's goal, and he was left clutching fresh air. And the home crowd are shocked, stunned. Wasn't in the script for the African nations champions. And they're going to have to play like champions now to respond. Well, in the build-up to this game, the Kenyans had said that they weren't going to come here to lie down. They were mentally strong. They fancied their chances. No one else did. Stephen Kitchy, the Nigerian coach, had warned the squad, the players, the federation, the Nigerian public, that the party was over after the African Cup of Nations. And Kenya looking to even score a second before half-time, but fell there on Sunday Mbar, who hasn't really been involved much in this game. Victor Wanyama spreading it wide. Well, that seems to have given the Kenyans confidence as well, because they're certainly pressing greater numbers in the Nigerian half now. Well read by Kenneth Amiru. Good pace from the youngster and skill. Plays for Chelsea. On loan, though, in the Dutch league with Ado Den Haag. Manmart's Didier Drogba out of the game in the African Nations quarter-final against the Ivory Coast. Well, Nigeria have themselves a free kick, but further out than the one that Kenya scored from just moments ago. The big defenders, Godfrey Obabona in the box. Ranobi Mikel, the man to take the free kick. And again, not really hit with much power, and it just comes off the head of Brown Day. And Solomon Kwambe, the 19-year-old for Nigeria, in for the injured F.A. Ambrose in a number of enforced changes for Nigeria today. Striker Emmanuel Emeriki and Ikech Uche both sidelined through injury as well. Four minutes to half time. Kenya lead by a goal to nil. in Nigeria. Here's Moses. Good turn and shot. Just past the left-hand post of Origi. 22-year-old doing well there to get his shot off. Never really looking like it was going to go in. Well, you feel there's going to be some team talk if it stays the same score by the half-time whistle for the Super Eagles. Kenneth Amiru, the man down. And even though he won the African Cup of Nations, first Nigerian to do so, Stephen Keshi, such is the state of Nigerian football, a couple of defeats and he could well be on his way. Keshi, the 19th coach in 19 years since Clarence Vesterhoff guided Nigeria to that second Cup of Nations that Keshi featured in 1994. Keshi calling for some stability to build his side, say we're not yet a good side, we're on our way. But they're trailing at home. Remember, never been beaten by Kenya in 13 previous occasions. Kenya with only two wins away from home ever in their history in competitive international football. What an upset it would be. Mikel. Ball watching, really. And they had that period where they briefly threatened Nigeria with Moses to the fore, but apart from that 5 minutes, you have to say that the Kenyans, who stuck to their game plan and have appeared relatively comfortable and have taken their one opportunity to be presented to them. Sunday Mbar doing well to win the ball back, but given away. Well, they defended well, the Kenyans, as Nigeria press for an equaliser. Approaching injury time in the first half. Nigeria 0, Kenya 1. Mbar, scorer of some crucial goals recently. Moses looking for Martins. Oh, well worked. Moses, it was the last man. The well worked 1-2, but again, the Kenyans are there to cut out the danger. What's happened here? It's the same time wasting. Well, to look at that one again. Not happy at all with Sunday Mbar. Arnold Origi not happy with the referee's decision. Lining his wall. worrying moments, head in his hands. Adel Amrouchi, he won't want to concede right at half time. And as you can see, it's inside the penalty area, and Kenya more or less lining up the whole team in front of their goal, as you'd expect. Mikel, who's been taking all the free kicks for Nigeria in this first half, wants to take this one as well. Godfrey Obamona there, the central defender, looks like he could hit it. Semba! Well, the Kenyans fast to react. Frustrating for the 51-year-old coach. Short corner. And Godfrey Obabona, the Sunshine Stars man, heading it over. Actually started as a right back with the Eagles, and since he was brought in to the squad, he's played every minute in the African Cup of Nations and was a revelation, and says he wants a big move in the summer to a top European League side. But his side at the moment, Nigeria trail as the halftime whistle goes. Kenya lead by a goal to nil from that man after a wonderful free kick in the 38th minute. Origi was beaten from a corner, but the header was cleared off the line, and Nigeria have generally disappointed. It's their first game since winning the African Cup of Nations, and they're going to have to do better in the second half. They lead Group F by a point from Namibia. One team going through to the third and final qualifying round, and Nigeria plenty of work to do if they're going to get the 3 points and get back into this game. Join us again for the second half.
It's a muted scene here at the UJS.
Half-time, it's Nigeria 0, Kenya 1.
Absolutely expecting, and as it is going into the second 45, the Super Eagles are trailing the Harambe Stars of Kenya by a lone goal. Goal scored, amazing free kick, you have to say there. It's been a rather tepid performance from the Super Eagles, so more is expected by the time they come back in the second 45 minutes. So nerves are still calm, and of course we want the Super Eagles to come back second 45, and of course take this game by the scruff of the neck. We'll take a break. Second 45 minutes analysis, standing by.
All right, just to confirm the scoreline after the first 45 minutes, Kenya lead the Super Eagles by 1-0, and it really has come as a shocking result after the first 45 minutes. African champions, they train Harambee Stars by 1-0, goal scored by Francis Nyambura in the 36th minute. We are going to take a look at all of the talking points, and some of them very controversial as well. Let's quickly start off with the 23rd minute, and Shega will take us through this one. And here we're talking about the clearance off the line by Duncan Akech from a Brown Idea header here.
Both the goalkeeper and his right back, and they managed to get the, you know, Nigeria's major problem in the first half is possessing the ball, but not being penetrative enough. It's a problem. And we frittered away our set pieces. You know, during the week, I read that the Eagles were practicing set pieces and free kicks and corners. I've not seen that today. And what the Kenyans have done is, this is a typical away performance from a well-drilled side. All they're looking out for, looking for the counter-attack or looking for a set piece, which they've utilized. So, you know what? We really need to sit up. We need to take more advantage of the possession we had. We mustn't slack off the pace. I mean, that was a very good opportunity we had to score. But the truth of the matter is, we've not stretched the Kenyan goalkeeper enough. He's not had to work hard enough, you know, considering that we're playing at home to Kenya.
Okay, you've also got to talk about participation, and one particular player, in my opinion, who hasn't really stood up to be counted, you'd have to mention the likes of Obafemi Martins. His placements, his runs off the ball, not really top notch in the course of this game, but your opinion might be different.
Well, you know, Obafemi Martins is actually a player you play in the middle, up front, let him score the goals. He's a really good finisher. He's not somebody you want coming back, you know, to collect the balls. For Nigeria, they want him to come back. He's been in the centre circle, coming back to pick up the balls.
Well, let's take a look at this. How controversial is this? Was this, should this have been a penalty in favour of the Eagles?
Well, from the angle I was looking at it, I won't call it a penalty, because Mikel was actually playing for it. You know, he had the ball quite all right. He had control of the ball. And what I saw, there were two Nigerian players that were actually free for him to give the ball, that could shoot the ball. I don't know why he chose to go down.
Okay, so in your opinion, it wasn't?
It wasn't a penalty.
It wasn't. Referee made the right choice. Shegun, what's your take?
I disagree. Yes, on one part, I do agree that there were some players free in the box. I think he should have passed the ball quicker, and that's the problem we've had in this game. We've not released our ball quick enough. But I do feel, I think there was contact there. Maybe he went down too easily. Maybe that's what the referee was looking at. But my first impression was a penalty. But you know what? The referee's decision is final. It wasn't given, and we paid for that. But I disagree with you on both of you on Obafemi Martins. I think the Nigerian midfield has held onto the ball a shade too long. They don't release the ball quick enough. And Obafemi Martins is a player that feeds on the ball being played into space.
When you mention Obafemi Martins, how would you say, you know, as we talk about his performance, his runs off the ball? Because as a striker, you've also got to run off the ball as well. Has that been satisfactory for you?
He's done okay for me. Yes, maybe he's played a bit too deep, because he's getting a bit frustrated. He's isolated up front. He's not getting the ball. What all Keshi needs to tell the ball in the second half is to release the ball a shade quicker. Ball retention, discipline at back has been okay. But you know what? Release the ball quicker.
Okay, let's talk about goals, because the game of football is mainly all about goals. And as far as the African continent is concerned, this is where you see the very best of it. And Francis Nyambura, in the 36th minute, well, he produced what a lot of people, a lot of players around the African continent will be very, very envious of. Absolutely nothing that Iyama could do about that one.
Definitely, you know, the ball, I was watching the ball from here, and the whole world here just stood still, watching the ball, praying that Iyama could get to the ball. But, you know, Iyama could dive from today till tomorrow. He couldn't get to that ball. It was a well-struck free kick, perfect, and it was a good goal.
Okay, what sort of changes are we possibly looking at, you know, when it comes, as far as Stephen Keshi is concerned? We've heard so much about the expertise of a certain Nnamdi Odumare, the possibilities of him making an entry in the second 45.
Well, we need more speed. We have to get behind the Kenyans. Jonathan and I were talking about, they've scored the goal they were looking for. Basically, their game plan was to get a draw, which is what they were playing for up to that point. They can walk away with all 3 points, all well and good, but the major thing is that they've done what they have to do. The onus is on the Eagles to chase the game. In order to chase the game, they have to get beyond a very, very well-organized Kenyan back four, beyond their mid, because they're just going to sit deep now. And they have to do some pace. Maybe an Ahmed Musa or some creativity, some wizardry. Maybe if Duarte can do that, that's what we need. But the way we're playing right now, we've simply not been able to. It's not good enough to break down the Kenyans.
Okay, we're going to move away from the top here and move down to the bottom and catch up with Moses Praise. Now, he's got people at the helm of affairs. And here in this vicinity, in this area of the African continent, we refer to these individuals as the Oga at the top. And Moses has got one of them standing with him. Let's take a look at who Moses has got with him standing right there at the pitch side.
All right, the truth is that, Charles, if there's anybody who's Oga at the top, it has to be you, because you're right up there. But again, I'm right here with the governor of Cross River State, Senator Leah Limoke. And not many of us are too happy that the Super Eagles are down by a long goal in the first 45 minutes. But again, this has been a great hunting ground for them. They've never lost on this ground. And I don't think that's going to happen on your watch.
No, certainly not. I know they're down one goal, but I believe that in this second half, they're going to make up for that. And as is usually in Calabar, they'll go away with a win.
All right. Tell us exactly what was the feeling like when you saw them come here with the trophy, knowing for a fact that they have been your tenants, so to say, for a very long time, towards the qualifiers and, of course, off to AFCON.
Well, yes, we've been very excited having them here with us. And we've always been encouraged by their play. Mm-hmm. We've always felt strongly that they could win the African Championships. Mm-hmm. So bringing the cup was very fulfilling for us, mm-hmm. but it was not unexpected. We were a bit more, not as skeptical as most Nigerians, because we watched them play, we watched them train, and we grew to understand them, and there was confidence that was developed from that relationship.
All right, well, what exactly is the issue with this lads now? Because second 45 minutes, something has got to happen. We can't let the Harambe Stars live here with a win.
No, I understand that the Harambe Stars have never, ever beaten the Eagles. Mm. It's not going to happen here. I expect that... if they were a bit flat-footed in the first half, I expect them to come out more agile in the second half. I'm looking forward to a win.
All right, then. Yeah. Thank you very much. The governor of Cross River State, Senator Leah Limoke, confident that the Super Eagles will leave here with a win, even though they are trailing by a lone goal. Second 45 minutes is standing by. Let's see exactly how things will be shaping up for the second 45.
Welcome back for this second half, this World Cup qualifier between Nigeria and Kenya. Can the Harambes beat the Eagles? It's never been done before never mind in Nigeria's own backyard. The last time Nigeria lost in a World Cup qualifier was back in October 1981, losing to Ghana in Lagos. Well, that's the prospect facing that man, Stephen Keachie, there, as the Kenyans lead Nigeria by a goal to nil. We're about to get underway for this second half. Martins brought back in from the cold. Didn't really impress in that first 45 as the Botswanan referee, Joshua Bondo, about to get us underway. That man, the Kenyan coach, first game in charge. And as it stands at the moment, he's looking like making it a historic game for Kenya. It's Kenya to kick off this second half. Francis Imbola Kahata, the man who scored the goal, a superb free kick in the 38th minute. And we'll wait and see how long Stephen Keachie takes before making a change. Claims for a penalty for Nigeria in the first half. Mikel, the man over, bundled over in the box, not given. They also had a header from a corner cleared off a line, and a couple of shots that Arnold Origi in the Kenyan goal did well to come out and smother. And Kenya, with their very first real dangerous chance, took it with that free kick. And a real feature of that first half was the way they defended in numbers. But it's a corner to Nigeria, an early corner in this second half. Victor Moses will whip it in, looking for the head of Godfrey Obona, but the ball over Origi's crossbar, harmlessly wide. Actually, it was Elderson Aguili on second look, the left back with the header, the man who actually was booked for his challenge that brought the free kick that led to the goal. One other booking in that first half, Victor Wanyama, the most famous name in this Kenyan starting 11, the 21-year-old Celtic midfielder who helped Celtic into the last 16 of the Champions League, scoring against Barcelona in a famous 2-1 win at Celtic Park. And if the score stays the same here, it'll be an equally impressive feat for Kenya. Never beaten Nigeria, played 13, lost 11, drawn 2. Those are the statistics. Plenty of time, though, left in this Group F World Cup qualifier. Nigeria, the leaders. Kenya, rock bottom. Cross coming in, looking for Martins, but Origi can claim. Martins now playing for Seattle in the MLS American League after leaving Levante of Spain. Nigeria do have plenty of talent on the bench. The likes of Nnamdi Udomandi, who plays in Italy. What can the men do on the pitch at the moment? It's Adeyu. The red shirts again forming a wall, and they can counter-attack with the goal scorer Kahata, but a strong challenge from young Solomon Kwembe. Free kick Willinga Munandi. Bringing Sunday Mbah down and, well, looked two-footed after he'd gone through the challenge there. Mbah plays his football in Nigeria with Warri Wolves. Moses and Mikel, the two Chelsea men, standing over the free kick. Moses whipping it in. Clear header. Oh. Martins completely unmarked, and you have to say he should have at least have made Origi work harder for that one, but took a deflection. The header going wide anyway, I feel. But that was a real chance for Martins. The Kenyan defence caught napping for once there. Moses. Kwambe back to Moses. Hustled out of it by Owino. Ababona. Amuri, rather, recovering well against the lone frontman for Kenya, the captain, Dennis Oletch, who's led the line without much support. All part of the tactics of the Harambee Stars coach, Adil Amruchi, in his first game, whose tactics, you have to say, are working so far as they lead Nigeria by a goal to nil. And Andy with the throw-in. Well worked. Kayati's offside. Nigerian skipper Vincent Enyama, who listed the Nations Cup, known as a fantastic shot stopper, but he really did have no chance with the Kenyan goal. Martins not happy with Joshua Bondo. Attitude. Babona can get Nigeria underway again. Mikel with a long ball, looking for the run of Brown Adey. Kenya can break. Good, strong challenge though. Moses switched again, left hand side. Good turn of pace into the box, and the Kenyan defender had a nibble there. Moses stayed on his feet and wins another corner. Yep, just stuck his leg out there, but Moses stayed on his feet. Kenyans will look to mark better than they did with that earlier free kick that led to Martins with a free header. And evades all players heading towards the touchline there. A throw in to the visitors. Just 1 point, Kenya, from their two games so far. No goals. Goalless draw against Malawi at home and a defeat in Namibia. But this, if it can stay this way, will get them right back into contention. Tactical change here. Edwin Lavetsa, the man coming on. Thank you. Anderson, Akili. Well, surely it's not going to be long before Sinikechi makes a change. Second half, Kenya still lead by that goal to nil, scored in the 38th minute. Nigeria on a long unbeaten run, stretching back 14 matches to a defeat in May to Peru last year. Beaten run under threat. Struggling to find a way through these two banks of four for Kenya. Oletch looking like he played for that one. The Kenyan skipper wins a free kick. Will give his teammates chance to get up in support for the set piece. 28 years of age. Well, he certainly was blocked off there by Kenneth. Only three men forward for the visitors, the Harambee Stars, for this free kick. It's over hit, showing the level rather of their ambition to protect this lead. The onus on the Super Eagles to bite back. John Obi Mikel playing that sitting position in central midfield, looking for Martins. Solomon Kwambe has got forward, the right back. Lucky clearance from Duncan Achieng there, fell to his own man. Lingi Munandi force back. And that's what Nigeria are going to have to do. Looking for Martins with a turn, but safely back to Arnold Origi Otonio in the Kenyan goal. Been a real feature of this game. Some atrocious passing from the Nigerians. Solomon Kwambe, the culprit this time. Worried faces on the home bench. Going to make a change. It's going to be Ahmed Musa, the CSKA Moscow forward, who's going to come on. Some surprise that he didn't make the starting lineup. He scored 4 from 6 since returning to Moscow after the Super Eagles triumph in South Africa. He's a real talent, just 20 years of age. And I would guess that it'd be a straight swap for Martins, unless he opts Stephen Ketchy for another man forward and take someone off from the midfield. We'll wait and see on that one. They are trailing, of course. Corner though to the Kenyans, the goal scorer there, Francis Yambola-Kakata, the 21-year-old with a whipped-in cross that's dealt with by the Nigerians. Again, not giving them time to settle on the ball. Brian Mandela. And it is Martins who makes way. That one-headed opportunity just minutes after the restart from Martins in a rather disappointing return to the first team and the squad for Nigeria after being left out of the Nations Cup winning squad. And it's Ahmed Musa who has the burden to try and restore parity for the home side. He shows some skill there, just loses his way. He looks like he's quick. Kombe with the cross that Origi comes out and claims. Small goalkeeper, but seems to have a good pair of hands. Oh, he'd love to get his first game in charge of Kenya, off to a winning start and a famous win at that. The Adel Amrouchi, Algerian born, Belgium. Mikel. Here's Musa, peeling off to the right hand side. Not a conventional centre forward, it seems. Solomon Kwambe with his run up. He's going to take a long throw and test that handling of Origi. Again, Kenya get it clear. Time not quite running out yet for Nigeria. But certainly a concern. Never expected to beat Ivory Coast in the quarterfinals of the Nations Cup, Nigeria. And at the moment, it looks like they're going to be on the wrong end of a major, major surprise here in Calabar, the southern coastal town in Nigeria. Moses. And another corner. Wide from Godfrey Babona, who certainly looks like he's a main threat from set pieces for Nigeria. Plenty to ponder for the former Inter Milan man, Martins. Kahata. Lively presence on that Kenyan left-hand side, but he's given away a free kick to Emiriel of Nigeria. Moses. Going to shoot. Oh, lovely ball. Origi with the save. John Obi Mikel did really well there, shaping to shoot, selling the dummy. And you feel that the ball should have been passed on one more time with what looked like Moses on that far side, and frustration for the supporters in the stands. They'd come to celebrate. Looking for the ball over the top. Skip up, Olech, but easy for Vincent Anyama. The Lille goalkeeper, who's actually on loan in Israel with Maccabi Tel Aviv at present. Delighted to be back in Israel, he says. Six seasons has spent there in his career. Voted Africa's greatest goalkeeper this century, Vincent Anyama. He knows all about the World Cup, making his debut in 2002. But this man wants to reach Brazil, Moses. Twisting this way and that, force backwards. Again, the Kenyans impressive in their rearguard action. Oyech, bit of pace to win some territory. You can see how hot it is, humid as well here in Calabar. Munandi with the throw-in. Carter losing out. Miguel with a storming run to Ahmed Moussada on the far side. Wins a corner. Brian Mandela there. He's been impressive at the heart of the Kenyan defence. Short corner taken, but again cleared, and Nigeria just can't find a way through at the moment. Nigeria yet to lose on home soil since being shocked 4-1 by Ghana back in 2007. Well, the Kenyan player there being stretched off as we see a replay of that wonderful strike. Goal scorer it is, who's been carried off. Maybe a touch of cramp as well. That's the African Cup of Nations, lifted by Vincent Anyama a month ago. But it's the World Cup and Brazil that is on the agenda here in Calabar and Nigeria at the moment. Struggling to get back into this game. Just a bit of drive missing in midfield for Nigeria. Trying to go wide with the balls to the front man, but little creativity in the centre. Mikel looking for a bit of creativity to Solomon Kwambe, the fullback. And you feel the Nigerian fullbacks really have to gamble full time, really, be convert to wingers, with Kenya only having the one man, Dennis Oletch, up front. this really would be the amongst, if not the shock of the round in Africa. Third round of matches in this second qualifying round of the World Cup in Africa. Kenya's World Cup qualifying campaign began actually at the end of 2011 when a first round of 12 two-legged ties between Africa's 24 lowest ranked teams kicked off. Kenya beating the Seychelles 7-0 on aggregate to reach this second round group stage, where the 28 higher ranked nations such as Nigeria entered the fray. Group F, one of 10 groups of four, the winners of each group going through to the final eliminating round, which takes place in October and November. 5 two-legged ties to decide the five teams from Africa who will go through to Brazil next summer. That's what's at stake. Sunday Mbah, Moses to Mikel. Good running off the ball from Brown Adeyi. Cuts it back though. And read by the Kenya defender who goes down. Now, are we going to have some more changes for Nigeria? The one change so far, Martins off for Ahmed Musa, a forward. Around 15 minutes or so of the second half to go. Nigeria 0, Kenya 1. And they've all worked hard, the Kenyans, as a unit. Edwin Mwatsa, the one change for the Kenyans in this second half. They're a man down for this throw-in. Can Nigeria capitalise? Mikel, frustration from the crowd as it goes back to Kwambe. Robert Bona, the centre half, operating on the wing. And the linesman flagging for a free kick there. Kenyan's not happy with that. Running at Mwanande with his head in his hands. Moses will be the man to take the free kick. Mikel is in the area. They're going to use his height. Two men being asked to go back the 10 yards. What can the Chelsea man deliver here? A major impact at the Africa Cup of Nations. Can he be the star saviour for the Super Eagles, the champions of Africa? He's going to book the goal scorer, Kahata, for not going back the full distance. Third booking of the game. Second for Kenya, Victor Wanyama. Kahata in the book. Elderson Akili for Nigeria earlier in the first half. Moses, far post. Looking for the head of Godfrey Ebobona. Kwambe. Again, the long diagonal. To that. Left-footed cross. Asking for a handball. Brown and deep. Gonna be a double substitution, one for Kenya, one for Nigeria. Oh, Kenya's second substitution. And Sunday Emba, who scored the winner against in that African Nations final, is replaced by Lumandi, young forward. Another chance for Nigeria. Moses. Oh, good connection from, looked like Mikel. Again, a wall of red shirts denies the Super Eagles. Cheer from the Kenyan supporters making the noise in the stands. Still Kenya 1, Nigeria 0. Still, Nigeria retain possession. Kwombe with the header. Acrobatic clearance. Oliech can't quite hold the ball up. Musa's there, the young striker. Moses doesn't win a corner this time. Well, it really has been a tremendous effort by the Kenyans. Just a reminder, if you're just joining us, they lead Nigeria by a goal to nil. They've never beaten Nigeria before in the 13 matchups they've had. Never won more than two games away from home in international competition in their history. And it's also the first game in charge for their coach, Adel Amrouchi. The Algerian Belgium. And that man, 51-year-old Steven Kitcher, who became only the second man to win the African Nations Cup as a player and as a coach following Egypt's Mahmoud El-Ghahari, has plenty to think about with time running out. And it's Kenya who have an opportunity from the throw-in. Half cleared. Substitutes getting involved. David Owino. Goal scorer Francis Mbola Kohata. Oh, good ball from Oledge. Chance for a second. So close. Wonderfully worked between the goal scorer and Oletch, and the left footed, and he put it wide, just trying to side foot it past Vincent Enyama, and a bit of the turf as well caught under his foot. Rather unlucky. And as Enyama spread himself, Francis Mbola Kohata missed the target. And if that would have gone in, it would have been game, set and match to Kenya. As it is, Nigeria still in the game. And rather than maybe trying to win the game, just at the moment, trying to get back to get a point. He's not there, surely. Origi, the goalkeeper. Yep. Joshua Bondo, the 35-year-old Botswanan referee of 6 years' experience. Blows for the foul on the goalkeeper. Shake of the head from John Obi Mikel. Missed out, Mikel, on the World Cup in South Africa in 2010 through injury. Won't want to miss out on Brazil next year. Had a good season for Chelsea. Made the team of the tournament in the African Cup of Nations. Again, a Kenyan defender needing treatment. Every shirt back now. Every red shirt back in their own half. As Ideu lofts the ball into the area. Acrobatics from Musa. Odomani still has a ball, and well, that deflection could have been dangerous. Again, though, heroic defending. Malingi Monandi clutching his legs. Victor Wanyama, so strong in midfield. Tackle and the clearance. Nigerians asking for handball. With Mikel in the first half, they were asking for a penalty, both waved away by the Botswanan official. Eight minutes or so to go. 1-0 Kenya lead. Good skill though by Ekieye. Again, calls for a penalty. Gahata clears, and Olech, with a job of holding it up, loses out again, straight back to the Super Eagles, who are forced to go backwards. Hitting it long. Mandy on loan from AC Milan with Varese and Italia's Serie B. Moses Diel Musa. Musa again, but frustration growing for the Nigerians. They expected a glorious homecoming, the champions. Rather rude awakening, clearly off the chest there of the Kenyan man. Skipper Dennis Olech led the line on his own, really feeding off scraps. He won't mind that if his side can win a famous victory on Nigerian soil in this Group F World Cup qualifier. He's obviously had a few words from the officials. The coach, Adel Amrucci, who is being told to sit in the stands for something he said, telling his players to fight and have a few words to the referee and the officials. And so close to glory, he's going to watch the remainder of the game from the tunnel, actually, while it's organising from the pitch. And Joshua Mondo, Botswana, gets us on the way again. Tensions stretch to breaking point here. The Kenyan backroom staff organising matters, maybe making another substitution as they cling on to their lead. But rather comfortable, you'd have to say, at the moment. Mikel Kwembe. Kwembe with the race back with goal scorer Kahata. Nigeria reduced to long balls. Can Kenya do? They got four men over in the Nigerian half. Substitute Edwin Lavazza, tall, rangy figure. Poor clearance though. Straight to Namandi Udomandi. Musa with the first time cross. But it eludes Brown Adeyi on that far left-hand side. Mikel with an opportunity to shoot, scuffs it, chance! Great save from Arnold Origi. Once again, quick off his line. Mikel's scuff shot ending up into a great pass, but Origi, the man, cleared his lines. Racing off his goal line. Substitutions as we head towards full time, with Kenya leading by a goal to nil in this Group F African World Cup qualifier for Brazil. Young Victor Moses making way. Worked hard today, but not been his day. John Ogu coming on. 6'3". Central midfielder from Academica. And it's the Kenyan skipper. He's not going to stay on the pitch to lead his team to victory. It's been hard for him leading the line on his own with no support. And he makes way for his teammate, praying that they can hold on to this slender 1-0 lead. Kenneth Umeru who's formed a solid central partnership with Godfrey Obabona at the back, that's kept out Joseph Yobu from the, not just the team, the squad as well. Fancy back heel there from Ugu. Just didn't fall to a green shirt. Keshi, plenty to ponder. No respecter of reputations himself. He won't want to lose, if he does lose this match, he won't want to lose too many more. There's 19 coaches in 19 years, Nigeria. Doing well, the substitute Odumande, but just running out the pitch. Time running out. Some supporters already leaving the UJ Stadium. A quick check of his watch. Stephen Keshu. This wasn't on the cards. There's a card, a yellow one, for Arnold Origi for time wasting. He won't mind that. The man from Lillestrøm, who's had a good game. His footballing family, Uncle Mike and father and cousins who play the game, will be watching this, I'm sure. Delighted with events so far. Not over yet, though. Precious seconds remaining. Enyema with the long ball, looking for the head. The Bugu again. Goal kick for Kenya. Remandi, who's now popped up on the left-hand side. 3 forwards in the box for Nigeria. Kenya defending as they have done the whole game. Disciplined, mentally strong. Adeyu, clattered. Does well there, Musa. Adeyu chasing for the ball in the box again. Oh, the frustrations boiling over. Brown Adey leading with his head there. Brian Mandela didn't like that. Ogu coming over as well. And frustration boiling over for the champions. Long throw in. Evades everyone. Chance! Oh, it's there! It's there! It's the substitute, Mandy Odumande, breaking Kenyan hearts right at the death. Their resistance crumbles, the long throw-in, evading everyone, and a lucky break falling to the man. The 22-year-old on the far side, the crowd delighted. Stephen Keshi, no emotions on his face, but obviously relieved. And the bench for Kenya is devastated. Right at the death. Musa's throw-in, overhead attempt from Adey, and the man, the only man who wasn't marked in the box, smashed it home. Nigeria 1, Kenya 1. There it is, the full-time whistle. Kenya denied a famous win right at the death. He's not celebrating. So close to pulling off an historic victory. A consoling pat for the goal scorer, Francis Kahata, whose free kick in the 38th minute had given Kenya a short lead. And Nigeria, in the second half, ran out of ideas. And it took a throw-in right at the end for Nigeria to equalise, and it's finished. Nigeria 1, Kenya 1, and Nigeria have got out of jail, the group leaders before this game, and Kenya, who have never beaten Nigeria in their history, denied right at the death. And you can see from the faces of the Nigerian players, they know they've not played well. The African champions, they're not happy, but they've scored at the end. They haven't lost. They maintain their unbeaten run, which stretches to 15 matches. And for Kenya and their new coach, Harambe Stars coach Adel Amrouchi, who was sent to the stands for dissent with 5 minutes remaining, pride in the performance, ultimately disappointment though, having come so close. Delight though for the Super Eagles supporters in Calabar, this southern coastal town who'd come to celebrate the champions of Africa who won the Nations Cup last month, but have been misfiring this afternoon. But how crucial will that goal be at the death? Captain Vincent Anyama with a consoling pat on the shoulder for his counterpart Arnold Origi, who had no chance at all with that final finish, having played so well over the 90 minutes. And the Kenyan supporters, plenty to talk about. They'll have hope for the remaining games, this return fixture against Nigeria, as well as second legs against Namibia and Malawi, the other two teams in this Group F. They've been organised, dogged, determined, and no little talent on display as well. So shades of optimism for Kenya and their supporters. Nigeria will know they can do better. Maybe the celebrations, the aftermath from winning the Nations Cup has had its effect. They didn't perform, but they've scored right at the death from the substitute. And the supporters being asked to stay in their seats. I wonder if they're going to present the nation's trophy to show the home supporters. Vincent Anyama didn't really have much to do over the 90 minutes. Clutching at thin air, though, for the Kenyan free kick. It went right into his top left-hand corner, the roof of the net. And they'll be debating this one long into the night in Kenya and Nigeria.
All right, so after 90 minutes, it's ended one goal apiece here at the UJ Eswene Stadium.
After 90 minutes, it's finished
for the
at the UJ Stadium.
FIFA World
Nigeria
Cup.
Won.
And a lot of people out
Kenya
there,
won.
Surprises, African champions, they had to leave it up until
thanks for joining
late
us.
To get an equaliser. And Nnamdi Odramadi coming
now.
Off the bench and getting the equaliser for the Super Eagles. And they are going to have to go all the way to Nairobi, Kenya for that return leg, which will be ultimately very crucial. But you've got to look at it in terms of the positives. The Super Eagles didn't lose this game, and now we have 5 points, and that makes us still remain at the top of the table as far as our run is concerned. And guys, you know, when you look at it in totality, it wasn't much of a performance from the Eagles, but at least, I did say earlier, 3 points not lost, 1 point in the bag.
1 point, but you know what? First is congratulations to Kenya, the Harambee Stars. They got their game plan almost perfect. They were a couple of seconds away from bringing, you know, pulling one of the biggest smash and grab, you know, robberies in the history of the African game. They played to their coach's instructions. They were strong, very, very well organized in defense. And just a moment of sloppiness has cost them all 3 points. You know, as we at least credit the Super Eagles, African champions with fighting spirit. They fought to the last whistle. But there was a lot of lethargy about Nigeria's play, which I'm sure Steve Keshi will address when they go to Nairobi for the second leg.
Okay, and when you do look at performances from the players individually as well, we're going to be talking about that as well. And we also do have interviews well, down under with Moses Praise. He's going to be catching up with quite a few of the personalities here at the UJ Eswene Stadium. Find out, get their perspective, really, as far as this particular game is concerned. 1-1, it's ended, just in case you just joined us here at the UJ Eswene Stadium. Live game coming to you courtesy of your World of Champions Super Sport. Before we move on over to Moses, let's quickly get the thoughts of Jonathan here. After 19 minutes, what's your take on the game?
Well, you know, it was always going to be a very difficult game for Nigeria because coming back from the Nations Cup, the success and everything, and playing against a team like Kenya. I think this game would be expected by Keshi. Nigerians would not really like it, but, you know, it is something that would be, it is really normal. Because coming as the African champions, you are expected to play against a very defensive team, and the Kenyans really did it, they made it very difficult for Nigeria. So, you know, the positives of it, Nigeria didn't lose the game. You know, we take the 1 point and we look forward to the next game.
All right, so lots of expectations for the Super Eagles based on the fact that they are African champions. But looking at the players individually in terms of their performances, what would you say, what's your take really? Especially for those who've recently come back to the side, and Nnamdi Odramadi, the goal scorer as well. Solomon Kwambe at right back in the place of Efe Ambrose, what's your take?
Kwambe was excellent. He had a very, very good day, played very, very well. Obafemi Martins, he's lost a bit of pace, but I still feel that the midfield didn't release the ball quick enough to him. But for me, I was in South Africa. A lot of our players that had excellent games, had an excellent tournament, didn't really come to the party today. Victor Moses was strangely indecisive today. And when Ahmed Musa came on, his decision-making was all over the place, you know? So the truth of the matter, I tell you what, on the basis of play, Kenya actually deserved to win. They executed their coach's plans down to a T. I don't think Steve Keshi should be absolutely happy with the way his boys played. But you know what Jonathan said? The Kenyans were never going to make this game easy. And I tell you what, it's a tough group we find ourselves in. Not on paper, obviously, but we just have to do better. We have to be sharper and more dynamic in our approach play.
All right, as we look at both coaches from the two sides, of course, you'd have to make mention of Adel Amrouche, who was actually sent off in the course of the game for, you know, unpleasant words said to the assistant referee. But when you look at both managers, especially with Stephen Keshi, African champions now, a lot of us, a lot of people around the African continent, and maybe even around the world, believe the Super Eagles should be at the FIFA World Cup in 2014 in Brazil. What Keshi recently stated was that the Eagles will qualify for the World Cup, and beyond that, will make it all the way to the semi-finals. What's your take?
Well, that's kind of like a tall order. You know, it's achievable, but at the same time, they have to put a lot of work into it. Today actually brought everybody down to earth in Nigeria that, look, winning the Nations Cup does not give you automatic ticket to go to Brazil for the World Cup. You know, they played up till the goal. We were actually controlling the game, but after we conceded the goal, our whole game just broke. There was nobody, no player that was actually concentrating because, you know, the goal just took all the strength that we had to attack. So it was a very difficult game for us after the game, we have to say. And, you know, Keshi has to really, really work because after we conceded the goal, we didn't do much in the attack. There was nothing in the attack to trouble the Kenyan defense. You know, there were those runs that we saw at the Nations Cup. There was nothing. Mba was marked out of the game. I have to say, you know, Wanyama, he actually, after the goal, he controlled the midfield systematically because every time Mba had the ball, he had to come out from defense to actually just knock off the ball from him. So he was knocked off his stride most of the time. So there was nobody carrying the ball for us from the midfield into the attack directly.
All right, we did catch up with the goal scorer for the Super Eagles, who did come off the bench, and we are going to be speaking with him later. Find out his thoughts. Remember, he used to be part and parcel of the Eagles. Now he's back in his side once again, and he did get the goal as well. As we take a look at the Eagles making their rounds, and of course, saying a big thank you to the fans and supporters who've come out in, well, large numbers really here to support the Super Eagles and Vincent Nyama, showcasing the fact that indeed and truly we are African champions, and he's got the trophy there to prove it. And just like champions, they have rallied, come back from behind, and they've equalized this one. So all hope is not lost. There still is a long road to go as far as this qualifiers is concerned. And remember, it's a 10-group thing where top teams from all 10 groups qualify and then move on to the third round, where the qualifiers will now emerge for the FIFA World Cup. As we take a look at the highlights coming from the second 45 minutes, quite a lot of incidents to look at, quite a lot of controversial incidents as well. The goalkeeper for Kenya, lots of time wasting, booked in the process, an indirect free kick awarded to the Eagles. But that's the goal as we take a look at Odramade getting the equaliser for the Super Eagles, guys.
I like to blow my trumpet. I actually said when he was coming up that he was going to score. I just had a feeling because I spoke to Stephen Keshi when he was in our studios on Monday Night Football, and he spoke about how he missed this young lad, that it was a pity he got injured just before the work, before the Nations Cup. And there's something about him. He came on one or two touches, and today it was the child of destiny in the right place at the right time. Because I tell you what, as the clock was ticking down, I thought the Kenyans had done enough to hold on, you know, to all 3 points. But the guy came up, and unlike the others, he actually belted the ball and did quite well.
Okay, let's take a look at, confirm for you some of the results, really. And just to let you know, Malawi actually defeated Namibia away from home. So another shocking result coming out of the qualifiers for the FIFA World Cup. And as it stands, that's exactly what it looks like. Nigeria alongside